Welcome back to the show. I can't get over a John Bucker.
Yeah.
That voice, the first time I had that voice, I kept on asking, who is that? Who is that? Who is that guy? This guy, he's good. By the way, you have to, you cannot just come and go. This voice has to stay. We can't wake up one morning and then we can't hear John Black anymore. It can't happen like that.
Even John Black Jr. will be like me even more than
me.
John Black Jr.
And you know what? He keeps on telling me mutakuwa. As in, there is nothing he uses. There is nothing. He doesn't drink. He does not smoke. Is that true?
Yeah, it's true.
How come?
I'm a Catholic boy. I'm a sabi kulira. Mama is really strict in you. Then I'm from mtu yogenze chakala.
My friend, that's exactly what women do to their husbands. Hey.
Pastor,
it's
midnight.
Now we know what you do.
What I do?
No,
I said that's what women do to their husbands. But anyway, so tell me about your upbringing. Where did you grow up? Where did you go to school? Where did you? We ask these questions. I mean, you're no more. Where did you go to school? I go, how many times have I done it? But you, because you have just arrived in this industry, we want to know so much about you.
Yeah.
So take me back. Where did you grow up? Where did you go to school? If you went to school.
I grew up in Jinja. Rwanda Primary School. I started from Rwanda Primary School. From P1 to P5, then I came to Kampala.
You came to Kampala? Did you come on a bus, in a taxi?
Yeah.
In a taxi?
Kukameme? I didn't get that at a good day. The interview is video. So, I was going to Christmas. I was going to
This is an English TV station, but I'm an African boy.
African boy.
Africans, we also speak English.
Yeah, we speak English.
So you came to Uganda.
I came to Kampala. I convinced the guy. I was like, tell Jeje I don't want to come to go back
to the village. Yes.
So the guy convinced Jeje. I was like, no, that boy is still young to be in Kampala. You know, Kampala boys can spoil. Let the boy come back. He'll come back later. I was like, no, this is the right time for me to be in the city.
City boy.
Yeah, city boy. So I started from Asantra B Primary School, P6 and P7.
Okay.
Then I joined Bwegere Secondary School. Still, it's called Asantra B Secondary School. I started from there, from S1 to S6. So I was like, now, man, I think it's high time for me to join music.
So, first, wait. Was it, there was no money? There was, why? Watch the way you're going to
get out. Sayagara.
Can you imagine? You didn't want to go to university.
I didn't want.
But in
I
case.
I never wanted to join university because even my, I never wanted to study. To be honest, yeah.
It was not your thing.
Yeah, but I'm foreseeing.
It only worked out, my friend.
But
let me ask you a question. In just in case you had taken a different path, no gamba, I will not join music immediately after my S6. What would you have studied at university? What is that thing, profession, cholaba, no gamba, second circular music. I would have been a good teacher, a good doctor, a good engineer. Chichiche wa chewe gombo kola. Go chali muto.
Me, I always wanted to do simple things. So I'm too stressing. Learn the bino yibatu kanibaga nti katisimanyi compulsory subject, simanyi which optional. Then I ronda Luganda na FN. I didn't want calculation. I never wanted to stress myself. Yeah, I never wanted to stress myself. So I was like, if I was to join campus, nandi badde nkola bino yibaba catering.
Kufumba, easy. But it also needs art.
Uliriza, nze chiso kaze, nkulide mu family nga nkole emirimu ayina otukoko
omubiri guno gulabika gwakola jobu
nakola nyo nemba sigendedde ku ministry I can cook something good so nze sagala bintu bin stressing a John Black era ambe okubeera kama ebina ndikoze ina mafrikana nenfuna omulimu
nekigwerawo Pia, if you hadn't done music, what would you have taken on as a profession?
I've already lied a lot.
Lied? You tell lies.
I know how to get myself
concoct any story. Yes. And get yourself out of trouble.
Yes. Hey. And I did a lot of literature. Na so mango buta bachukumi. I write because I like sex. Like I wanted like to sex. Know. Yeah. When I was young, I liked to know how sex was and what exactly was. You know. So I used to read a lot of yes. I used to read a lot of romance. Late, by the way. Late nyom.
Let you. How many years ago? We are talking.
No, Mary, don't misquote me. I'm saying, you know, when you're young and you're an adolescent, so to say, wow, like
your hormones 13, are everywhere. 14,
somehow you get to see people kissing and you're like, wow, that must be heaven.
But let me tell you, Pia, oh, Fana Nobu Kaba.
Many people think by the way in Dimkawa, but I'm not. Anyway, so I used to read a lot of novels. Banange, the romance. I would never read a thriller. For what?
You wanted to know romance.
I like romance.
You wanted to know.
Nanzugulao chapter 8. So I definitely would be a lawyer.
A lawyer.
Ganimba nyonga, mfera abantu, those things.
Lawyers, but then lawyers are very smart and intelligent people. Do you think you have that kind of intellect?
I'm very smart and intelligent. Mm-hmm. You remember that it's the first thing you noticed about me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Exactly. I told you you are. I told you people have the wrong impression about you. You are such
upstairs. City
brings me to my next question. Mm-hmm. Kenzo wa Musanga.
I found Kenzo in Makindye. Mm-hmm. Yali Tuesday.
Okay.
I was voicing to Bawe. Because I used his studio. But I didn't even know he was the owner of the studio. Mm-hmm. So this time around he comes back. He was from...
But Pia, when you talk about Kenzo, you all light up.
I like him so much. He's made me something. Aww. That is something. Like for me, when somebody says something bad about him, put it because they don't know who he is.
She's so passionate about. Guys, did you notice? As I said, how did you meet Kenzo? Then she suddenly lights up and she's like, I met
he's
him.
Like my
she's
papa.
Dying to talk about him.
Yeah. What,
you know? So he saw this brown thigh. Was it on display?
You know, like I always thought Basede Bubelaga. So when I saw him, he walked in and I didn't say hello. I just went on with my music. I was singing, Tibaweko Chakala. Then he was like, Bishop Yoyimba. Like, can't you sing? Then I jacked microphone, Nagama Yimba vote. And he had been there for like 3 minutes and he knew the whole chorus of my song.
Wow.
So he voiced it for me. Then he told me, Wobo Bikola, Bikola Nawe Mbikoze. And then I did it. He was like, so you can hear.
How many years ago is this?
This is 2017.
Yeah, just recently ago. Here.
Actually, when the year was ending, like more August, yeah. Okay. Yeah. So then later we made more projects and he was like, would you want me to sign you? Mm-hmm. I'm turning Big Talent into a label, not a group anymore. And I was like, yes. Then
what? Here, why are you rolling your eyes?
Then here I am.
I thought then.
It's called Mary for me. Oh, no. Gambo, you're a deep thinker.
I am a deep thinker. I can't even refuse. So anyway, so now the problem. You see, that's why I don't like to befriend musicians. This one here is my friend, so I can't even ask her hard questions. But sure,
by the way.
So are you sleeping with Kenzo?
No, I'm not.
Pia, why did you look down like this?
Because the chibuzo chibuzo.
Let me ask a question.
She has asked me that question the whole year.
Be my eyes here. If it look at her, if she looks like she's lying, Black, you tell me.
Yeah, if I look
Pia,
at her
I'm going to ask you the question again. Sorry. Are you sleeping with Kenzo?
No, I'm not.
Open your eyes. When you're answering this question, open your eyes and look at us.
By the way, why that? No, Mary, let me defend myself. One more time. It's like how somebody would ask you if you're sleeping with your dad.
Hey, so Kenzo has.
No. But to me, he's such a Jay-Z to me. Like, he's such a.
A Jay-Z to Rihanna.
Yeah, like, he's such a mentor. And, you know, every time I'm. Even if I showed you my chat, I call Eddie Papa. Like, that's how I address him. I can't even call him by his first name. So, Muntuambuze Chibuzoestio. Chidi obscene. Like, Chingua sends on you because Chidi. It's a little bit obscene.
Does Kenzo feel the same way?
Yes.
No way. Kenzo is a man.
I swear to God.
You think she's about to cry?
So bad. I am so bad.
You're such an actor. Go away even. So do you guys hear when they said, oh, Banange, Kenzo has signed this girl. This girl is very beautiful. Banange, Rema.
Bali ba mtisa.
Nenga, itoka chafumba.
By the way, where to lead her Eid near Christmas?
Eh? Mm. So it's like a family. She cooks very well.
I'm a new fumbo mchele, man. She knows. She knows.
Guys, the intros are done. The hard questions are done. Now we're going to break down 2018 when we return on. Please do not go anywhere. I've got Pierre Pounds on the side and John Blacka.
I'm like, I've got deep and delicious.
Can I work?
You do that. Black, so can you be deep and delicious?
You deep and delicious, man. Green and delicious. Pierre Pounds. Yeah.
Pierre Pounds, deep and delicious.
You're going to call
a collab.
I'm
connecting Zedda.
We'll be right back.